There are several key messages involved here. The first one is that based on long-term follow-up of several randomized trials, axillary dissection can no longer be considered standard care in all node-positive patients. We have now 10-year results of IBCSG 2301, ACOSOC C11, and the RTC AMROS trial, all showing that the omission of axillary dissection in clinically node-negative patients with positive sentinel nodes does not increase the risk of regional recurrence, and none of these trials found any differences in disease-free or overall survival. So that is pretty clear now that many patients do not need axillary dissection, even if there is cancer in the sentinel nodes. Most of the efforts in clinical research in this field of axillary surgery de-escalation now focuses on ways to determine that there is nodal pathologic complete response after neoadjuvant chemotherapy without removing all nodes. So limited concepts of axillary surgery, and these involve mostly the sentinel node procedure, but also similar concepts that use clipping of the sampled nodes and selective localization under imaging guidance in combination with the sentinel that's called targeted dissection to reliably show with a low false negative rate that the nodes are clear and the patient can then be spared axillary dissection. And now we have oncologic follow-up of the first series showing that these concepts most probably work just fine. And then we wait for the data answering the question if we can omit axillary dissection in case of residual disease. There is the Alliance trial that reopened now that recruits very well. And there is the Taxis trial that tries a new concept of tailored axillary surgery in clinically node-positive breast cancer. So axillary surgery de-escalation will go on in the next few years.